it's only sort of now that we're starting to realise the difference between what some people would refer to as equality and what others would refer to as equity. That it's looking at individuals in terms of where they have started from. Whereas equality says, you know, we treat everyone the same. Equity actually says we put the right resource within the right place at the right time to enable all to be on the same level playing field.
So what equity looks like for me as a woman is being able to give women that flexibility in working and not having to act like a man to be able to do a job. Women have monthly cycles or going through the menopause or there's pregnancies or, you know, they have childcare and running a household and then having a full-time job. Equality for women is just giving that voice to women to be able to feel heard and to understand the issues that women feel. I think that's really important.
Yeah, there are lots of biblical teachings in line with the empowerment to women. For example, if you look in the Bible, you know, the Apostle Paul says that men and women are equal and before Christ.
Then all that unpaid labour and those care and responsibilities that often still sit with a woman regardless of what trauma she's going through. People who are living in the YMCA, trying to hold down a job, trying to do Fat Macy's, but still have to go and check in on their mum and help her do her bills because her mum doesn't speak English, and that falls on her because she's the daughter in the family. You know, there's all that extra stuff that sort of sits with women regardless of their experience and what they're trying to manage.
Women who break that chain or that cycle of challenge and frustrations and issues are inspirational to me, because it takes a lot when you're perceived by society in a particular way to be able to come above that, and regardless of the issues that face you, you break through in some way, shape or form.
Not having to feel like a man in a workplace, but being able to embrace femininity and being a woman in a workplace.
Sort of the hats and the stereotypes that women carry in relation to their emotions and therefore in relation to their trauma. There are so many stereotypes of the strong woman. She carries all the burdens. She can hold it all together for everybody else. Or the angry woman. Or the overly emotional woman. And actually, what does that even mean? And if you're processing trauma, like at what point does that become overly emotional and not just a very natural response to your current situation?
We can have hormones and we can be vulnerable and there is a strong emotional side to us, but to accept every aspect of women, not when they are performing well and not when they are well only, so to speak, but even in their hormonal stages, and appreciating their weakness and vulnerability. That is who we are, you know, not accepting us only when we are doing well, but accepting us even when we have those emotional moments.
Women are so powerful, and women create towns and villages and cities, and it's the women in the communities that band people together. And I remember growing up, and it was the women who'd cook, and if they had a little bit extra, they'd, you know, come and they'd drop you up at your house. My mum's friends who would pick us up from school and would go to their house and they'd look after us and feed us tea and then drop us back home. And so it's women that look after each other. And even if I have childcare issues, I'll look at, you know, female friends who could help me out. Women do create cities, families, towns. And I think it's so important to nurture women and nurture women's mental health.
In John 4, Jesus talks to the Samaritan woman in the middle of the day. And in that day and age, men did not generally converse with women, and especially not with the Samaritan woman. But kind of Jesus talks to this woman so gently and with respect that she finds her identity. She discovers herself, who she is.
We are taught as women to be humble and not to brag, and if you're too confident then you're a show off or you're bossy. So we have to put a, I find we have to put a lot more time into our female service users to really get them to understand and identify and believe in their strengths.
It's so important for women to mentor other women, purely because I think women have a very special bond together. And there's a sisterhood that's unspoken. And when you go into an organization or a business, or, you know, you go into a shop and there's a female that, you know, they understand the struggles that females have.
Again, in John 8, there was the situation when the Pharisees and the teachers of law brought this woman who was caught in adultery to Jesus to be stoned to death. But Jesus says, you know, let who he has no sin, you know, be the first to stone her. And everyone left. And so Jesus did not condemn women. And in fact, what he did was he was so empowering. He treated women with respect and love and gentleness and such grace. Like, he kind of, I think he broke the pattern, the cultural norm of the day. And then the women could, so that the women could find the identity, you know.
I guess the most empowering thing you can do for somebody is facilitate them discovering their own strengths and really believing in them and developing their self-esteem.
It's time now, isn't it? It's time, because we've been talking about this for what feels like centuries upon centuries. And it is time that we just acknowledge that we need to move on from just talking about it, but actually making some significant changes.